And we're going to see a huge difference, I think, in the way he approaches it this week. He's been grinding all week long. He had yet another good performance over at Suplex City this past weekend. He had, I think it was 25th. For him, that's never enough.
I was going to say, he's like, he didn't do too well. I was like, well, you got 25th. Yeah. Like,
I constantly have to get on people's backs. You know, like, getting any type of position like that at these PGRC teams around the area, that's hard in Tri-State in any.
The talent's
like,
there, bro.
It's really difficult. He ran into the Buzz, and I forgot who he lost to and lose. But, going into game one. Last week, again, Ling had a hard time kind of really closing the gap against Intero Bank. Normally, he's very, very good at that. And punishes the setup of Void repeatedly. I think we're already seeing that he's just kind of trying to fade his way in
right.
to see how often he reacts with it so he can punish it accordingly.
And I talked about this earlier, and I'm glad that we get to see it in practice now. Like I said, that conservative playstyle is like just well matched by another conservative playstyle. And Ling knows how to do it perfectly. So we see him take these advantages when he can get them and just even up or even take the lead with the percents. After taking a couple straight hits, he went right in with down air forward air and evened it up.
Yeah, now, that's the big difference between these two is that while Intero Bank can rack up the damage slow and painfully, Ling could do it painfully all at once.
Right.
All he needs is one interaction to be able to like either break the gap and lap you heavy or get a confirm into a kill. Like, it's much easier for him.
That's the thing. Like, you see all those Peach combos on Twitter. First of all, Ling is the one posting them.
Yeah, he's the one who creates most of those.
And he's the one doing them in bracket. I've seen him bring people on a grand tour of the stage right to left and right to the blast zone.
Yeah, ask Hawk. He has been the recipient. But actually, pretty much every wolf in this building has been a recipient of Ling deciding to go off.
But that's why I love... Oh, the dot eye is huge. That's why I love...
That dot eyes was so important. It gave him such huge stage positioning because of it.
Nice.
And he's going to get, that was perfect. He waited just long enough so he couldn't tech. And when he had to fade back in, then he pulled in there so he could get him to go sideways.
That is one thing I do like about Intero Bank's playstyle. Probably the only thing I would be comfortable saying I like about the playstyle. But it sort of prevents those explosive starts from Ling. And that's huge.
Yeah, and it is relatively one of the more optimal playstyles to play against Ling Ling.
Sure.
Like, because of the fact that he's so passive, and he's going to close it out with that forward smash, he can slowly annoy Ling enough that Ling has to commit where Ling wants to set up instead.
Right. I got to watch out for the tree, of course. Only 1%. Like, we talked about the Ling show that first doc, but, you know, Terra Bank kept it close.
Yeah, that's the key. Just, like, to keeping the damage at minimum as possible. Well, see, only 2% versus... like a down tilt to a full combo or these nairs, like it's so much longer for Intero Bank to get the work that he needs to succeed against Peach.
Also something I feel like people don't talk about, not a lot of villagers in the game right now doing the work, but some stealth buffs for villager in the form of no power shielding. You have to be sort of in shield and parry the projectile for like way less.
Yeah, outside of pretty much I think only Stock Taker, and he plays multiple characters.
Right.
I don't think I've really seen other... like,
I mean, thank God, like, right?
Yeah, they've kind of tapered off.
Oh, huge. Big back throw here. Yep.
Offstage. Oh, and there's Bobby Wasabi. If you watch it, I'm sorry. I forgot you, Bobby.
Robert Wasabi. Can't forget. All right, but Intero Bank wrestling back that stage control. Big down air from Ling. What is the play here?
And super cuts. Now I'm all of a sudden remembering everyone.
All right, back air out of shield is a huge thing in this matchup. I've seen it a lot. I've seen this matchup specifically a lot. And Ling will put his back to Intero Bank at the ledge, and we'll do three or four of those in a second.
Yeah, forcing him at the ledge again. Wait, crap, I just remember another one. Is Panda Bear still playing Villager?
Bro, stop. No.
See, all of a sudden I'm remembering everyone. So, bring it up, Nightmare. So, this has been such a good, perfect second stock for Ling. There it is, catching up with the fair, but perfect DI from Intero Bank to go to the corner.
That's that tricky movement with the float cancel as well. You saw it. Definitely messed up the timing of Intero Bank shielding. But.
Yeah, and this is now see Ling gets to play his game as well. Just kind of floating around, just hanging back.
That's the thing. Like I said, after Ling has like a substantial lead like he does now, then you can see him break out the conservative playstyle, much to the chagrin of a lot of viewers.
Yeah, and getting the back air there to close it up. But you got to do what you got to do to get that W. And but a big something that happened last week was when Ling committed to that, he actually ended up getting run back on. But that was part of the fear that he had in approaching him. He wasn't really respecting shield. I think Ling this time is like, you know what? I'm not even going to bother to respect the defense defensive options because I'm just going to play back and not worry about run-up shield anyways.
Exactly. So you got it, bro. I think it's working out. So far, Ling going to pull another turn. Play at a nice, comfortable mid-range. Oh, man. And the thing is, too, like you can't be playing afraid. We talked to, you know, Ling would say he's playing afraid. Villager is definitely a person who can capitalize
exactly
any hesitation.
Yeah, when you start getting too overcommittal, like you're trying to find the, like your way back in while being afraid, that's how you just keep getting hit and hit. And RNG's coming in to the play.
Spot dodge? What's the play?
Still I think he's trying to play around pocket. Okay. Yeah, he was not trying to let Captain Awesome get a hold of that.
That's a lot of knockback.
Winky face.
All right, nice jab. Whoa, I love it.
Slap him off for positioning. He almost had that roll read, too.
All right, Link's trying to get the stage control back throw here.
Yeah, he was just holding his ground, waiting for his opportunity. Didn't go in too early. Yeah, he called him out, jumping a little bit too early, and he actually still died to that. I mean, we weren't the only ones who had that look.
My face went.
Like, what? All right, so Ling, he played it the right way.
Yeah.
After that first stock, it was much more even. But it's like you said, the moment that he got a good substantial lead, like, all right, now.
Just floating above the smash roll, the stadium platforms, waiting for Interrobang to answer. And what did he do besides, like, aerial the middle of the stage, hopefully?
Yeah, it's quite literally in this matchup when it comes to Peach. Yeah. Anything you can do, I can do better. And she can stall just as easy as, Villager can.
Exactly.
And while holding a high enough position with that float, outside of committing to up air, really can't do anything about it.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's see, though. Have at least one game to sort of think of some new options.
We got the first game on board. And again, this is only a best of three. The only winners, losers, and grands will be best of five.
All right. Wow. An ambitious dash attack, but Interrobang just holding his shield the whole time.
Yeah, again, he's committed. You know, he's always committed to just running up and shielding. Like, all right, look, I'm going to hide in my bubble. This is my space. Stay out of it. Ling wants to break that very bad, but the moment that he catches him slipping once, one down tilt, and then good extension on that hit to actually commit to that fair there.
Wow, and the timing of the get-up attack, pretty smart as well. Let's see what he got here. Has an awesome ledge here from the back airs, but none are going to connect. Oh, there's that up air you like.
Yeah, again, like that's really all he has. He can't, like, he has to commit fully, and he's doing it now. Like, I realize you're trying to play the slow game against me. I'm going to try and catch it before you get all the way up there.
Exactly, yeah. All right, and that is another thing, too. If he catches Ling jumping with those forward airs, all of a sudden it's Captain Awesome's advantage. Interrobang's advantage.
I've given up.
Yeah.
No matter how hard I try, I don't think I'll ever be able to fully commit to calling him Interrobang.
Ooh, wow, nice grab.
All right, both of them just kind of, again, it's like continuously fading in and out. It's almost like both of them want to take the dance floor, but nobody really wants to be the first one to take the step out there.
They're just like eyeing each other up, like, bro, are you going to come center stage? Because,
I'll
meet you there. Like,
the song slaps. Like, you want to come? I'm just saying, we can do this.
Like, just tell me when you're going, bro.
Tell me. All right, you get back up? All right. I don't want to be the one
next
center.
Next song.
All right. No, for real this time, though.
Upbeat coming out. Ling trying to get a little cheeky, take the stock, but going to lose the lead for it.
Yeah, a whole 2 minutes in. Again, like, this is very similar to what happened in the last game.
Yep.
Both of them dead even. First stock is so important between these two, and that Lloyd almost giving Interrobang the first one.
Definitely, but just barely holding on to that first stock. You're in the back airs, but the forward air is going to give Interrobang some room to breathe.
That's actually a huge weakness now with when it comes to this matchup, too. Back throw. That back throw should take it. Yeah, that's good. See, now Interrobang gets to play his game. He takes the stock lead. Ling has to commit to going in. And when you need some help, just when you thought you needed a little bit of help. But actually, he's just going in now. He's just throwing out these nairs to potentially try and grab it.
The homie coming in. Oh, I love it. See, that's the thing. Ling has practiced these combos, too.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not going to shield the Saturn, he's definitely still bold, rash.
Yeah.
All right, pockets it, but
There you go. Just throw out that back air, catching him, trying to go back. Because if he breaks the shield, Ling's dead.
Yeah.
Like, you just die, whether it be a tree or forward smash, you explode.
Yeah.
Ha!
What? Are you kidding, bro? They're coming out. The Saturn family reunion.
So we've committed to the cause.
No,
he's gone. So we've committed to the cause that we believe that Ling actually sacrifices the souls of tags that he takes on Elite Smash to RNG.
Oh, maybe. I mean, is that why he doesn't, like, did he had to move out? Y'all are worried about the sacrifices.
Yeah, he's consistently sacrificing our stocks in Smash 4, and now he's taking Elite Smash tags in this next one.
Wild, bro. All right, but evens it back up percentage-wise. Interrobang giving up all the stages for a nice use.
I 100% believed with all my soul that he was going to pull a stitch face there, but it was not.
I would have put money on it, bro, and I'm not even a betting man.
Mr. R is. Can we get some of that luck?
Right?
I'm just saying.
Ling has it right now. That's the problem.
Yeah, he needs, right. Now, he needs to calm close down, his though. Stock. Like he closed the gap really well, but now it looks like he's got a little bit of that fear again, trying to find like his opening.
Yeah.
He's trying to play it perfectly smart, but that just plays into Intero Bang's wheelhouse. Like when you wait too long, you play right to his game.
And that's the problem, man. We saw a couple forward-airs come out, and they're just not hitting. Ooh. Finally, forward-air from Intero Bang, giving him the stage control, looking for the stock. So smart, covering the Peach Bomber.
Yeah, he hasn't done that one time so far. It's like, all right, I'm going to put this out here because I know you're going to be committed to like trying to get back quick. Oh, that could have been a shield break, and Ling got out of there quick. That
would have been on some crazy sort of villager combo, I'm sure. But
he's trying. He's trying repeatedly. Oh!
Peach Bomber answered back, taking the stock.
Hold the cakes. Yeah. You may have got the fruits, but I got the cakes. Mm-hmm. And that's going to put Ling back down to potentially...
Oh, Dot Eyes is huge, but it's eaten by the shield. All right. Off to the ledge is Intero Bang. Down smash finally connecting for Ling. What's the chase?
I think Intero Bang's going to be trying... Like, he's going to try really hard to play that long game now because this is his potential last stock of the tournament.
Only 2 minutes left, too.
That's
something
true.
To think about. 2 minutes is not a long time when... You have all the stage to run around on.
Yeah, he's more than willing to play the clock.
Oh, wow, but Ling, so much damage. Almost evens it back up.
Yeah, that's what we were talking about before. All he needs is one interaction versus 17 or 19.
Right.
I don't even want to know.
Too many.
I never want to take a tally of how many times that Captain Awesome or Taro Bang throws out aerials in an entire set.
I want him to scroll down on that little list in the results screen, you know, like how many times he grabbed the ledge, how many times he did an aerial of some
How many slingshots have been shot?
Yeah, exactly.
That could be potentially a good punish for Ling. Oh, but he put himself just enough far away.
Punish.
No, that was a really good punish.
Because of the platforms, that almost could have been a four-year, but Ling's just going to take the back air, and that was not the misinput that the Intero Bang fan wanted to see.
Yeah, 105 to 91 throw. Now, that's going to give him position advantage. Forcing him to go low. Gets him on the get up with the back air, but it's not going to kill.
But that's the thing, dude. The balloon's just extending how long that move lasts.
Dot Eyes coming in. And he texts it.
But
he texts it again.
The update.
Texts it a third time.
The back air is coming out. Back at the ledge. 172.
Oh, Ling was in a position to punish the air dodge. And Intero Bang somehow walking away with his life still.
Oh, my God, dude. This is still... anyone's game for no reason. Back air coming in, the back air forward air.
And kill throws are online for both these players right now. Oh, and he got him with the second one, and we're going to game three.
Ajax, the fact that Intero Bang got hit by the parasol was probably what decided it.
Yeah, it forced the bowling ball to drop
instead
on that trade.
And not even that, the fact that it slowed him down, right? It made Ling stuck in that sort of hit stun.
Yeah.
If he just snapped the ledge, it would have been fine.
Yeah. Just barely made it by, but we're going to game number trace.
And people always wonder about the tech skill, bro, you know, because Intero Bang, he should be hitting forward air and back air. Mm. But we saw literally the tech skill come in when he did it. All three of those were deadly.
This is, by the way, everybody saw Code Force go over there. We had 11:32. Thank goodness we switched to best of threes.
Yeah.
But if Intero Bang wins the next match, well, he's going to go up against Light.
Okay, so that's fine.
Yeah, so.
Thankfully, that would only be loser's final. So
yeah, it'll be loser's final.
Mars
patiently waiting. Yes. Actually, no, he's not patiently waiting. He's been playing some. If you guys see in the corner there somewhere.
Yeah, actually, right behind the Hawk who just did that cartwheel.
He was moving
Coup
like that
there.
In the set against Intero Bang.
I'm saying, right? That's him rolling, bro. Rolling to ledge every time.
He could have. I'm not going to say that. They're playing a board game over there. That was terrible.
There it is.
That was so bad. That was awful.
That was a Fox forward smash.
That was absolutely terrible. No.
I have shame.
No.
I'm not gonna.
I'm on the mic. That's what I'm here for. I ain't trying to bust my ass. Hey. This is some high octane game.
He did it for the fans.
Yeah, he did it for the fans. He's trying to amp it up for the fans. You could have done it for the fans if you wanted to set. So.
that's what they would have liked.
All right, going into game number three here.
Oh, the Stitch. Ajax.
Sacrificing him. One of y'all on the stream.
Check the local
one
farms,
of your
bro. I'm worried about the livestock. All right, he's out of options, though. Stitch, okay, no. Like, obviously, he still had up B, but like, he's running out of jumps and air dodges to ledge. But Ling is very fine just forcing the pressure with
exactly.
The Stitch.
Like, he hasn't done a single thing, but... Oh, and he pockets it. That's huge.
Oh, no. And that saved him from the forward air, too. This is so...
That is an instant shield break if he catches him with that turn up. Oh, he just walks up to it. Oh, Oh my god!
The bravery.
The titanium set that Wing has inside between his legs to walk up to that and not get hit.
That nair was so sick. I love it.
Yes.
Oh, okay, gonna make it back.
Oh, if he had a triple turn up, he could have gave himself great positioning to potentially get that stock early.
Oh, I love that wave too. Turn up gonna force him off the ledge. Backer gonna force him off the stage. What do we got? Forward air.
I think this is a big reason why Ling picked this stage is because of the fact that Turbank loves jumping from the ledge so much.
Right.
He's got to commit to potentially getting caught on that platform, and he can't really just – he can't hang back nearly as much as he can. He has to retreat to a bad position.
Also, he's got to ride the wall if he goes too low, which is definitely good for Ling. With the turnips, possibly going to hit him while he's recovering, but not going to see a whole lot of action now because Ling is opting for that conservative strategy we talked about earlier.
Smash for Smash Bros?
Yeah.
Because he's hanging back on that platform. He's riding it out, but I see, he's trying to get Captain Austin or Itero Bank to get frustrated via his own playstyle. It's
right.
All right, look, I'm not going to give you that opportunity to catch me with these fares, and once you decide to commit too hard, I'm going to catch you off guard.
Oh, wow. Unfortunate timing. Big back. Oh, doesn't go for the grab. That's served up on the platter.
Yeah, I think he was looking for like a follow-up opportunity, probably a little bit stressed out there. It's like, you know what? I don't feel comfortable enough. If I whip this grab, I could potentially take a hard punish.
We can get tripped by one of the village aerials like that. Why does that move guy do anything else?
I don't know.
All right, and then here he is still staying vertical.
Oh, yeah, we're playing tag. We're playing cat and mouse.
This looks like Congo Jungle. Like, that's what it feels
kinda.
Like, you know?
Yeah.
Except instead of Ganon, it's Villager, so it's, like, worse.
It's because they wanted us to take in this wonderful scenery in the back, like we were talking about
before. Yeah, we did talk about it. Yeah,
that
architecture, bro. What Pokemon is that in the back? You know, in the back left?
I think that's Umbreon. Is that Umbreon or Espeon back there?
Well, I know Umbreon doesn't have ears like Espeon.
I'm blind.
I know, me too, bro.
Yeah. I can't tell what that one on the right is, but it looks close enough to Zatu,
like
so we'll say
Zatu.
Like
a person, honestly, but it'd be cool if it was Zatu. Zatu's one of my favorite Pokemon, never gets love, you know?
Yeah, kind of weak.
All right, back here.
We got it.
All right, back at the ledge. There it is.
There it is, catching that back air, and now Ling finally put himself in the lead. I think, honestly, we're going to see exactly what we just saw in that first stock.
Yep.
Again, like, I don't think we're going to see Ling commit to approaching heavy at all.
I'm going to take this time real quick. Just to let you guys know in chat, please, please stay tuned. Literally all of the sets after this are going to be
wild. We have Light and Mars coming up after this. They are in the weights. This is the trial by tribulation.
Yeah, yeah.
A true war of attrition going on here.
This is the price we pay to have the cool players on later.
This is you're right.
Yeah.
Say, if you are strong, you will stay. No, please stay.
Please. All right,
we're riding it with you.
The platforms here also give Ling a lot of options to sort of avoid the ledge plays from Captain Austin. We see him using them to sort of mix up where those aerials are being placed, and I think he's doing a really good job avoiding them.
And it takes away one more ledge trap option out of the fact that Captain Awesome, he knows that people want to jump on him a lot off that platform.
Right.
But when you could fade back onto it, it's like, all right, what am I going to take at most? A soured spot fair? Not going to be that bad.
Right. Taking the time to pull a turn up, get some parries in. Jab's just going to basically push him away, see what the punish is.
No, I like the empty out that time there, but he just opted to hold shield.
Right. All right. Got the big eyes. I don't know what to call that one. It's like a wow face. Like the flushed emoji.
The wow.
Yeah, wow. Oh, boy.
Yeah. It's Arabic again. He's committing to the left-hand side.
Oh,
he actually just barely missed that tech towards the roll there.
All right, so we're going to see a jump from... Okay, no.
Yeah, no, Ling just staying patient.
Now we'll see the jump to the platform, and there we... All of a sudden, he's got so many more options to get around. Deep offense with big quotes from Taro Bang.
Yeah. This is... Pretty sure we're playing chess right now.
I think chess is more exciting.
Yes.
I'll be frank. I've watched from chess.
Right, finally catching him with a fair that was strong enough to take out a stock. Not a sour spot, a sweet spot. And Ling, stow it. Not a single, like, just murder face almost, when he was sitting on that angel platform. Like, this is how you want to play in Taro Bang? I'm going to play this game better than you can right now.
It's like the Jigglypuff versus Fox matchup in Melee. You know, people always complain about, like, the Puff or the Fox playing Campy. It's just like a symptom of both of the players. Like, now Ling is playing Campy because it's like...
He has to. He has to reciprocate properly.
Right.
It's like, why? Like, if I commit too hard, I'm going to take so much damage that I'm going to allow him to get the life lead back. And we're in closing on a timeout. We're going to get there.
I think after that, the way the first attack went, Ling is definitely playing to a timeout. Not necessarily as his main objective, but...
I guarantee you that every point forward after this set, Interrobang will never, ever, ever allow Kalos to be a stage that Ling goes to.
I'm not sure what his options are. There's like two functional Kaloses. Like, Ling could do this on Unova as well.
They have gone to Unova, and Ling usually wins there.
Yeah, exactly.
So I think that might be part of why he decided to ban Unova and not here.
But if he bans both leagues, then you have to worry about
Triplats and
exactly.
company. So.
Right.
But yeah, like, Ling has completely countered the entire playstyle. Like, look, unless you commit, man, unless you come at me, I don't care. Like, this is, it's nothing you can do about me up here.
If I'm Ling, though, and I'm playing with this timeout in mind, again, not as, like, the primary, but maybe a secondary objective, I want to take the stock from Interrobang first.
Yeah.
Because, bro, who knows? You know, bowling ball or some garbage.
Exactly. That's
takes
that's
the stock, and all of a sudden...
Yeah, that's something you got to be worried about. It's like, I agree heavily. Like, he needs to take out this stock.
Also... I think maybe there is something to be said about... Oh,
there
wow,
it is.
Love that.
Yep. At 69% with a fresh, whole fresh stock,
yeah.
Like outside of catching him with a forward smash, which he's never going to get because he's not getting down
right.
to the ground.
Now only 20-something seconds left. Oh, my God. The platform's coming in, though. I had a thought for like half a second, too. I was like, I don't know, bro.
That, these forward okay. smashes are really close right now.
But like Ling knows because that's the one out that Interrobang has. Yep. Perfect.
Yep.
Plan. All right, just go off stage, bro. But, like, far away from the ledge.
Yep. And, Interrobang's already.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's it.
Already.
All right. Bro, are you serious?
Bruh, you...
Oh, no. Interrobang.
Bruh.
Just off camera, talking to T.O. about
intentional stalling. He just said, is there a rule against
stalling? Yeah.
Bruh, of all the people...
He was just, like, floating.
It, well...
Yeah.
Okay,
so having words with clipboards, he's right, talking about
so
it right now, but.
No bro, for real.
He had the lead.
I'm sorry.
Therefore,
all right. I'm just saying. Like,
Hawk, what do you want? No. What?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Do I have room in my car?
So.
I do.
Still having some words.
You'll buy me dinner?
Currently.